We begin with that internal investigation into two deputies and a civilian employee with the Wayne County Sheriff's Office. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Dave Llewellyn.
And I'm Carolyn Clifford. The investigation stems from politically motivated social media posts that many say cross the line. 7 Action News reporter Simon Shaked shows us what those posts said and the consequences that could follow.
Wayne County Sheriff Benny Napoleon says all three employees who allegedly made those social media posts are still on the job, but could face serious discipline if it turns out they violated social media policy.
The posts are somewhat concerning to many of the members of the agency.
Sheriff Benny Napoleon reacting to learning today about these Facebook posts allegedly made over the weekend by three members of his staff, at least two of which work for the Wayne County Jail. Part of one deputy's alleged post in reference to the presidential election reads, quote, "There will be bloodshed, but it will be worth it. Trump ain't laying down." Another deputy allegedly writing, quote, "I would volunteer to be on the front line for this."
I've been contacted by quite a few folks who are concerned about the tone. We have a social media policy that we're examining. We're also doing a thorough investigation of prior posts.
Napoleon tells us members of his department are expected to know that they represent the county and therefore must be responsible with any social media posts they make. That could also include an alleged comment by a civilian worker who also wrote, quote, "Trump exposed all the career criminal politicians."
I will deal with this issue. That's the message I want to send to the people in this agency and people outside. I'll deal with it.
With an internal investigation now underway, the sheriff is promising transparency and to send a strong message that accountability within his agency remains a top priority, not only during an election, but also afterwards. Because these are simply allegations at this point, we're not revealing the names of those employees. However, we did reach out to them on social media for a response to this story and so far have not yet heard back. From Midtown, Simon Shaked, 7 Action News.
Simon, thank you.